Hello, everyone. It's
Hi, and it's Honor. It's been a while.
long time. Welcome back, everyone. And
Yeah.
I hope you have missed us.
I hope you've missed us. And also, if you're new, I know there are some people who have just started listening to this podcast. So hi and welcome and thanks for listening.
Yes, there. Anna's got her tea. You're already.
Yes,
I'm
you haven't
already
got your
done.
tea. I'm
I
so
drank it.
disappointed in you. Like, honestly, I went the extra mile and I got a historic mug. It has a historic figure on it and it has tea. You at least you got a dog mug, but it has no tea in it. But a mug without tea is absolutely useless. And it's
Oh dear, I'm being called out here. At least it wasn't coffee. You should be happy with me.
that's a good point. For people who are listening, tea is much better than coffee, end of
Oh,
argument.
no. We plan to have a debate on here with some other people about coffee versus tea.
Yeah, we should. And maybe we should talk about couldn't be a segue into coffee houses for you to rant
Yeah,
about.
my absolute obsession. Anyway,
They
how are
should have
you?
made tea houses, honestly.
Yes.
How am I? That's very
How
nice of
are
you.
you?
I am doing good. It
That's
has been, yeah, a long and lovely summer.
yeah.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. The summer was chaotic, but
Yeah, one of the reasons we didn't do a podcast recording for a while was because we were at a camp, a Shakespeare camp, together,
it was
which was
amazing.
awesome. Yeah.
We performed, so we've spent a week together with a bunch of other people, including Natasha and Jessica, who have been on the podcast before.
Yeah.
And we rehearsed and then we performed Much Ado About Nothing. And it was
Yeah,
amazing.
I now know that play so well because
Yeah.
of that. And yeah. And every time I think of rain, I think of the camp, and I'm joking.
It was raining a lot. It was amazing though. Such an amazing experience, and I can't wait to perform more Shakespeare plays in the future.
Yeah,
Actually, I want
definitely.
to ask the listeners, what is everyone's favorite Shakespeare play? I need to know.
That'd be a good point, yeah. Because
We
I
have.
feel like you can't, it's like asking what's your favourite book, because you can't have a favourite thing. It's like maybe a favourite thing in a specific character category, like
Oh, okay.
romance or tragedy or anything. It's like, yeah.
Okay, what is everyone's favorite history Shakespeare play? What's yours, actually?
I like Henry V,
Henry V is great.
but I also, being a Ricardian, I also like Richard III.
Yeah. Rich the
Hard
Third is.
not to like.
We're also both going to read Rich the Second, which I'm very excited about. I'm really
Yeah.
excited about it. Anyway,
Yeah.
we were actually discussing before we came on the podcast today, Richard, obviously Rich the Third, and about his reburial,
Yeah.
because we found it fascinating. And we were wondering a really weird and interesting question, is that would everyone care so much if it was a more hated monarch like Prince John or Mary the First if they had been buried in a car park and suddenly found? Would everyone care if Mary the First had been discovered?
Also feel Mary the First is more well known, but she ties in the whole Reformation stuff, so she's more well of a well-known character, and obviously history writes her as not a great character. Maybe true, maybe not be true. We'll see.
We will see. We need to do more about Mary the First. I love
We
Mary.
do. I feel like I listened to a really interesting podcast. You sent me the podcast actually from History Cafe.
Shout out to them.
Yeah, we should like, yeah, that's a great, some great people with great podcasts. They're
Yeah.
awesome.
We do not know them, but we love them.
No, I, yeah, that'd be great if we knew them, because then we could have them on and then we could all have a conversation about
That
history.
would be
But
amazing, but
yeah.
sadly we do not.
That can just go in our list of like famous people we want on the podcast.
Yes, eventually. Yes, I definitely look up to them because I have an obsession with history being, I guess, revisionist history, about just all redone, and proving other people wrong, which is very satisfying.
It is.
I'm actually reading at the moment a book about Henrietta Maria, the wife of Charles the First, and it's absolutely fascinating.
Oh,
It's completely amazing.
cool. What's the book called? Sorry, what's the book called?
It's called Henrietta Maria, the Phoenix Queen, I think. I'm not a big
Oh,
Boris, but I have
that's
this
really funny.
roaring Leander Delisle, and I'm a big fan of her.
Right, you know what? I'm going to note that down in this notebook. It's actually the Home-Brewed Bookworm notebook that I have, just to keep my eye on, but it can go in there. It's important enough.
So organized. I just have a laptop.
I am not. This was like something I bought when we took a break from doing recordings. So this is the first time it's actually getting used.
Well, that's good.
I can
Oh
stay organized for like a week and then we'll forget that.
yeah. I'm not organized in the slightest. I hope to be. What have you been reading recently, Anna?
Oh, I've read Edmund Campion,
Ooh.
which was a really cool book on obviously Edmund Campion was one of the people who was killed during the Reformation. And that was really interesting. I've also read some Agatha Christie, which was just fun. It sounds a bit morbid to say reading about murder is fun, but it was fun.
Whatever.
I also read The Princess Bride.
Ooh, yes.
I'm recommending to everyone I meet, read it. It is great. It is almost better than the book. I read it very quickly. I loved it. I drank many cups of tea. It was brilliant. And I also read The 5-Minute Marriage, which was a Victor it's a Victorian novel by Joan Aitken.
Oh, I love journeying, Kim. I love.
Yeah, I found it hard to get into at first, but then like I really enjoyed it. It's like it's so ran such a random plot, but it's amazing.
I don't think I will, but I'm a big fan of one of my probably my favorite one of hers is Black Hearts in Battersea, and so weird, but I love it. It always makes me laugh so much because it's set as though the Jacobites won in the Jacobite rebellion, so they're ruling, whereas the Georgians are the rebellion, which I find hilarious.
Yeah, I really find that interesting, ideas of like writing fictional historical fiction on like what would have happened if this, like, someone needs to deal with that on the Armada. What if the Armada, Spanish Armada won?
That would have been, yeah, that
Chaos.
would have really everything.
Yeah.
What if Harold Godwinson had won against the Normans? What would have happened?
Yeah.
Like, that's going much further back. Or
What if Richard didn't die? So much would not have happened if Richard the Third did not die.
we should
But
write that book. What if Richard the Third did not die?
yeah, well, we know, like, we know he had a son. His son died in infancy. So who would have the throne been passed down to? And then what would have happened from there? Because couldn't like everyone be killed off and it would have gone to Henry the Seventh anyway?
Yeah,
Henry of York.
that's slightly depressing. Oh well. No,
That really, yeah.
I like the Tudors. They're fascinating, but I mean,
Yeah,
I like them as learning about them. I don't like them as people,
I don't like them
actually.
personally, but I love learning about them. But yeah. I
Yes.
wouldn't want to meet them, put it that way. Actually,
Yeah.
maybe I would.
Depends on which one.
It depends on which one. That's a good point. I probably wouldn't be welcome.
I don't think either of us would be welcomed by Elizabeth
Henry.
or Henry. Which
Yeah.
Henry?
But they're still absolutely amazing and awesome to learn about. Probably my favourite period in history.
Really, Judah's favorite. Interesting. Yeah.
Well, yeah, they're one of my favourites. I love like the Stuarts, that kind of era where like the gunpowder plot is happening, all this stuff post and pre-Reformation. And of course Henry. Not Henry, gosh, Richard the Third, don't kill me.
Oh no! Oh dear! What if he was called Henry? Oh dear!
Merlin's so confusing.
Yeah, I don't want another Henry. We have too many Henry.
No, we have too many here. We've got another Charles now, which is great because I so far I really loved learning about the other Charleses, and we might get another William, and would that be William the Fourth?
No, fifth, because there was William the Fourth, William and Mary, I believe. I think, if I remember.
Yeah, well, who was William the Third? So William the First was like the first king of England. Then his son William the Second, who died in that forest. William the Third, I thought, was the husband of Mary.
Oh, my brain.
We'll find out later.
My brain is dying today, so we will ignore that. I can't
Yeah.
remember.
How was, what were the book, what kind of books were you reading? Sorry, I should have asked that question like to you.
So I'm reading the Henrietta Maria book. I've also just read The Picture of Dorian Gray, which Natasha liked. And that was weird. I really enjoyed it though. I like Oscar Wilde. Not that I've read much by him. I've read The Importance of Being Earnest, and I've started Lady Windermere's Fan, but I have not read that.
Oh, The Importance of Being Earnest is really good.
It's deep. I love it. It's so funny.
The Colin Firth film of it is brilliant. Sorry, I interrupted again. Please
That's not,
continue.
I was discussing this earlier with several people, in fact, with my brothers. I've never watched it at all, but I've listened to
Elizabeth, go finish Lord of the Rings and go watch The Importance of Being Earnest.
what a comparison.
And go get yourself a cup of tea, like, please.
Okay, I will. I will do that right after.
Good. Good girl. Thank you.
Brief segue. I have been reading, oh dear, I'm going to bug you again, more of the Scarlet Pimpernel books. You also need to read that.
I
You
over how the turntables.
I think you'd like it though, it's very historical.
Yeah, I should. I don't know why I haven't sat down to actually do it yet. But
Yes, it
yeah.
got me into the French Revolution, and that is a fascinating
Oh,
period.
cool.
Disturbing, but fascinating. Last weekend, I went with a friend to the first weekend of the Jane Austen Festival, which was great.
I saw on your status and your everything. That
It was
was
so exciting. It was in Bath, and I've never been to Bath, and it was very beautiful. And I saw lots of people in Regency clothing, which was very exciting. And it just made me
especially as we
watch.
know your love for Regency.
I mean, I do have a love of Regency, but not as much as medieval and Stuart. But yeah.
Nice. Oh, yeah, you mentioned the French Revolution. And I wanted to maybe ask you, have you spent like much time learning about like the other countries, like the French Revolution, French history, American history? Because like for me, I've learned a bit about American history, a bit about French history, because a lot of that ties into the English history, obviously, because it feels like they were always at war with the French king or some in some argument, because like so you can't escape that. So have you spent much time learning about other countries' history?
Not much. So I've learned about the French Revolution. I've learned about very few parts, and I'm learning more about, well, leading from Henrietta Maria, who was French, I'm learning more about the Stuart times in, so pre-revolution France a bit. I really want to go into more French history, but I haven't had much time, but I haven't, not much. I really know nothing about, like, apart from like the Mayflower and like early American history, I know nothing. So that's also a thing I probably need to learn about. One thing I really do want to learn more about as well, because I am studying Spanish as well as French. I really want to learn more about Spanish history because I also know hardly anything. So that a long time ago, back when I was very small child, I did stuff about ancient Romans and Greeks and Egyptians, but not much. How about you?
Yeah, I spent, well, last school year, I spent quite a lot of time studying ancient Greece and Rome. It tied into the exam I was doing, so I couldn't escape that. But yeah, same with me. I've only kind of learned about the history of other countries when it's tied into English history, like Spanish, when I like the Spanish Armada and what else? Oh, was it Mary the First's husband,
Yeah,
who
Philip.
Philip? And yeah, I usually learn it when it ties, and of course Ireland during like Cromwell and everything.
Yes, I that's actually I was discussing that with my one of my brothers and my mum yesterday, I think. I have a serious lack of knowledge about Ireland, and I really want to learn more because I was actually born in Ireland, and that feels wrong. And I'm half Irish, so, and I know you're full of
Yeah.
but
Yeah, so much. No, I'm joking.
I But yeah, I really want to learn more about because I know that Ireland has is very proud of its history, but also has lots of interesting like folk legends and things that I really.
Yeah, definitely. And there's that kind of story of Saint Patrick getting rid of all the snakes of Ireland.
Yes, very
Probably
helpful.
that's pretty. Yeah.
Yes.
I feel this might be an abrupt change of topic, but should we talk about our plans for future?
Ooh, yes, let's. Because otherwise we will
Then,
get carried
yeah.
away. So we are nearing an end of the first season, which has been very chaotic.
But also, we just did the first season. Woo!
Oh. Hope you're all thrilled for the next season because I am.
Yes.
Really excited. So we have a rough theme that may go in and out a bit. We may have just a few random episodes in there that have nothing to do with anything, but we will ignore those. We want to focus on battles and warfare and things.
Yeah. And I feel like there'll be different kind of like, I don't know, periods of certain topics. Like as you said, battles and yeah.
Yeah, specific battles, maybe like also rebellions and what's the word? I don't know. But series of wars.
That's gonna be really fun.
Yes, definitely focusing on the Battle of Bosworth. Cough,
Of
cough.
course, well, we can't. Yeah, it's been like if we do once we do that, it'll be hard not to like talk about it again because it's like losing. It's like when we talk about Richard, like oh no, we can't do another episode on him for a while.
We will always focus on Richard. Oh, God.
Course, forever in our hearts.
He will appear in everything.
Yeah, he's just there. He's like the backbone of like the podcast.
He really is.
But he was like one of the reasons we did it because we thought, oh, we've got so much to say about him.
He is a never-ending topic.
Yeah, I think yeah, we'll probably there'll be probably some like techie things we'll be trying to alter. I think in the next few seasons, like shortening the length of some of our episodes. So
Yes. So
yeah.
hopefully.
So it's easier for you poor listeners to stick through an entire episode. And like I know a lot of you have actually done that, and I am so impressed.
I'm so proud of all of you. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I don't
Like
know
I'm
why
looking at
you do it.
analytics, it's like how have we got that many people actually listening to full episodes? If I were you, I would not listen to a full episode of Honor and Elizabeth ranting about absolute rubbish. I don't think it's rubbish. Yeah.
Yes, to the general view, it is absolute rubbish.
Absolute nonsense. And like
Yes.
but I also know a lot of our viewers have actually gone about and recommended it to their friends and got their friends to listen to it. So that's been really nice to
Yes,
see and
there are
like
other people we don't know.
yeah, it feels really professional, like having utter strangers to us
Yes.
listening. It's like, oh my
You don't
gosh.
know us in real life. Hello, I'm talking to you.
Yeah, we are talking straight to you and saying a huge thank you.
Trying to think of other things we're going to change. I'm not sure. Hopefully we'll have some more guests on at some point. Because I know people are
And
jabbering about wanting to
we
come
might
back
have
on.
some really interesting guests. Well, I guess interesting, sorry. We might have some interesting people lined up.
Yes.
This tea is amazing, by the way.
That's good. I'm glad. I think we have to end up this
Yeah, you
update.
should be. You
We're
should
going
know you
on
should
and
be
on.
enjoying it as well.
Well,
Well, thank you so much for listening.
yes,
And
thank
what
you
you were
so
going to
much.
say.
And yes, farewell. We will see you soon, hopefully.
You
Bye.
soon. Thank you so much. Bye.
Want to get in contact with us? Please contact homebrewedbookwormspodcast@gmail.com. All lowercase.